Hi, my name is Mandy. Thank you for watching. With cards number 306, you can make different cards like a slider card, a double slider card, a magic slider card, and more. Today, I show you a magic slider card. Die cut twice the largest rectangle out of red cardstock and once out of white cardstock. Die cut once the second largest rectangle out of green cardstock and once out of transparent sheet. To make it easier to die cut transparent sheet, first lay down a piece of printer paper, then the transparent sheet and then the die. Place the smallest rectangle in the middle of one of the red die-cut shapes to make a frame. Take the die with a semicircular opening. The long side of this die is a tool to die-cut the semicircle on the right spot. Place the long side of the die against the red base card, not on the card. The top of the die should be flush with the top of your red base card. Stick the die with non-permanent tape. Die cut with your die cutting machine. Take the other red and white basic shape and cut out the semicircle in the same way. Take the long straight closed die. This die has a cutting line on one long side. Place the die with the cutting line face down. Make sure that the side of the die, without the cutting line, is against the left side of the white base card. Stick the die with non-permanent tape and die cut with your die cutting machine. Now rotate the die 180 degrees. Make sure that the side of the die, without cutting line, is against the right side of the white base card and the short side of the die is against the top of the white base card. Stick the die with non-permanent tape and die cut with your die cutting machine. Take the small straight closed die with two small cutting lines. Place the die with the cutting lines face down. Make sure that the side of the die, without the cutting lines, is against the bottom of your green card. Stick the die with non-permanent tape and die cut with your die cutting machine. Die cut an opening in the green and transparent card for ribbon. Place the transparent rectangle on top of the green rectangle and stick with non-permanent tape. Now place both rectangles flush at the top with the white base card. Stick with non-permanent tape and flip the whole thing over. Take the small oval die and stick it with non-permanent tape. Die cut with your die cutting machine. You can make the card horizontal or vertical. I choose horizontal. The magic of this card is that the green rectangle is hidden and will be revealed when it slides up from the card. This means that you can add die cut shapes or stamped image on it that will be revealed later. I'm going to show this with silhouettes number 8. Stick Crayleys make a sticker out of your die cut shape behind colored paper and die cut both shapes. Place the left side of the green card, where the two die cut lines are, flush with the inside of the frame on the right. Make sure that the green rectangle is also in the middle in terms of height. Stick the horse on the green rectangle. Place the transparent rectangle on top of the green rectangle. Place both rectangles flush on the short side of the frame. Turn the whole thing over. The horse now disappears apart behind the red frame, but that's no problem. Stick the foal on the transparent sheet. Slide the two small die-cut tabs on the green rectangle through the die-cut lines of the white base. Make sure the top of the green rectangle is flush with the white rectangle. Use 3 mm red sticky tape on the green tabs. Remove the protective layer and strip the transparent rectangle on top. Make sure that the transparent rectangle is flush with the top of the white base. Stick 3 mm red sticky tape along 3 sides of the white base card. Make sure that the transparent rectangle remains completely free. Press the tape firmly. Stick 3D foam blocks just above the red sticky tape on the bottom. Make sure that you don't stick any foam blocks on the transparent sheet. Stick the red frame on the white base. Instead of removing the protective layer in once, you can also remove the protective layer in stages. Press the edges firmly. Turn the project over. Stick 3 mm red sticky tape along 3 sides on the back of the white base card. Remove the protective layer from the red sticky tape and stick the red rectangle on the white base. Press all edges firmly. Thread a piece of ribbon through the opening. When you now pull the ribbon, the green rectangle appears and the horse and veil are together. Your card is ready for further decoration. You can also use a stamped image for the magic card like Divina did. This is Anna's card. The link of the other 2 cards made with this die set can be found after March 25th in the description of this video. Have fun with cards number 306 and see you next time. Bye!